Welcome back, everybody, to our online basketball coaching clinic. It's my big pleasure to have Coach Fatih Emre Gezer, Beşiktaş assistant coach, as I know. Thanks for Murat Coach to help me to have these great coaches from Turkey. Today we're going to be talking about unexpected champion with JDA, Dijon, as I know, France team. Yeah. Yes. I'm excited for this session. Let's start, coach.
First of all, thank you very much to share my opinions, ideas with you about one different subject. I mean, like to tell not my things at basketball, try to tell the opponents' things to give some idea about how the mid-range teams can be built as a roster. Also, what is the strategy about to build a mid-range team and then playing for a like a champion. Why I said that this is an unexpected champion, because this is something that not getting by with the budgets or media is not showing that GDA Dijon team is going to be a champion. They took the trophy at the, as you know, is the French Cup by the from the opponents, is a very strong opponents, first Nanterre and after that Monaco, and after that they are beating at the final Asvel team. From this way they get the cup. Also, as you know, this is one of our opponent at Champions League, one of the strongest team at our group. After I spending many years at EuroLeague and EuroCup, and I was really lucky that I work with really good coaches. After this experience and try to play every time with a very good opponents, I learned many things at this range. Teams I never expected before. For sure, every level has some teams that really built it really good. But this team has a really good specialties, and we can get some examples, many examples from this team for every level, for youth teams, for the team that we are managing at our level. If it can be a second division, first division team, anyhow, it doesn't matter. Why I choose this team and this subject is the what is my point is every time maybe we are trying to get our philosophy, basketball philosophy, to one spot. Am I too much idealistic person, or some I need to be very realistic and win, you know? So this is one combination of these two things. You can be very idealistic person, at the same time you can be a winner. This is the thing that Dijon team is showing to us about every example of it. First of all, I like to start with by sharing the screen. Excuse me, please let me know to for I have one update here. Sorry. Yeah, okay. I will start with the defensive strategy of the team. What is their mentality? What is their goal about their defensive strategy? First, let's start with the main topic. Main topic about their defense. This is, first of all, let's start with the deflection. What we're going to try to tell about their deflection. Deflection is very important for their strategy. This is, first of all, everybody is very aggressive. Everybody's arms up, hands all the time on the ball, tracing the ball, deflect the passing lanes. Every time somebody on the passing lane by arm up, hands all the time in the contesting about the passes. Also, the every time they let you to not an open shot, every time they let you for a contest shot, if you are at the spot up situation, you will see also what is their mentality about their at their defense about the spot up shots. First of all, I really like to give the examples about their deflection strategy. Every time very aggressive, and after you catching the ball, stopping the dribble, every time they like to deny everybody else. It doesn't matter you have the shot or something. It doesn't matter. Every time they are denying you, not easy passes, let you to play far away from the arc with the range. You see that every time very aggressive. This is a very simple view about their defense, because every time they are in same shape, no up and downs. You see that after you catch the ball, they really like to use this situation. After you catch the ball, every time they push the button on and everybody is denying, and the guy who is on the ball, tracing the ball and don't let you to make easy pass. And this is another thing that you're going to see at the pick and roll defense also. The guards, the perimeters, it doesn't matter which one of this, never let you to pass you over your over his head. Every time hands up, every time hands is ready for deflect the ball, touching the ball, or let you to out of your plan. Again, you see that especially David Alston is using his hands on you, harasses on you every time. For sure, he's a small guard and he has some, maybe from referees, maybe he has some tolerance about this. Every time on you, they are not calling so much fouls. And he's using this. And we have similar examples at our in our Turkish league also like this. Sorry about this. I think about the internet, this goes a little bit fast forward. Every time they are attacking, the bigs also. As you see at the examples, this is Richard Solomon. He played at Turkish league, but we never saw him like that before. He's really aggressive on every pick and roll defense. Every time try to steal the ball. And this stealing attack is never by the body. They are never losing their balance, every time by the hands, every time they try to take out you from the comfortable zone. Let's go for the pick and try to explain the pick and roll defense. The same mentality on pick and roll defense is on is aggressiveness on ball. Every time they are really, really aggressive on ball, they are really rely on this mentality. Because of this, they are sometimes risking the weak side or one guy. So they are defending with they are defending four offensive players by five defensive players. Sometimes they are letting sometimes one guy who is far away from the ball always free and open. But this is their mentality. But they never let you to reverse the ball easily to that target. Their rules, I put it as a second thing that about their pick and roll defense. Their rules are always very clear. If they want to steal the ball from the first pass, every time they are coming, there is no hesitation. This is the thing that very helpful for them to play with this strategy. There is no hesitation, so everybody is very clear to come to steal or better reaction to lose his man and coming to another man. And because of this, sometimes the teams that who are the opponents of them, they are really ready to pass to the weak side. So they need to be ready for the rotation all the time for the closeout defenses. Every time they are going many rotations, you will see at the examples. You see that hands on the ball every time. Again, one guy come from the first ball to steal the ball. They never let you to see the easy passes at the weak side. And every time, this is the same picture at their defense, you will see. Million times, they are very aggressive, jumping on the ball. They don't let you the easy shot. And one of the things that you will see at the my other examples, this is one disadvantage to be in the rotation, giving some offensive rebounds. This is one point that they have many problems about giving offensive rebounds. But they know this, what is the disadvantages of this defense, but they are trying to act in a very, very good way. You see that again. This is their point guard. And hands up again, deflect the ball. He don't want to see you this pass over here very clearly. Because of this guy coming directly through from the guy at the weak side and seems like a one unforced turnover. This is one set offense. I think they are working for their opponent play, set play. Because of this point guard stay here. They just make a minimize rotations for the opponent's set offenses. One of them is this. This guy will be make an overload cut here. So this guy who is under the rim will be responsible for these two guys like a zone. And the guy who is defending the cutter, he's standing over here to steal the ball again. Because of the sideline situation, sideline pick and roll situations is really hard to defend by the weak side helps. But like I said, these are all about the rules that very clear and no hesitation about the defense. Again, one pick and roll after they return the ball and they let you to shoot the ball, not the first priority that the opponent have one pass, and after that they don't let for the roll man. Also, you see that how the guy staying on the middle of this two guy is an eye defense, and they let you a very good with a very good reaction for a closeout defense. You see that there is one thing that what is helpful to be a clear giving a clear information. A defense is very helpful for this guy who needs to be react for a very long way for a closeout defense. You see that with the pass, this guy start to run, not after this guy get the ball and he will start to run. So this is very helpful for him. You see that how he is far away from his guy and he can go to closeout. Him and let a contest shot over the hand. So this is the things that very basic, but I think that everybody knows these rules, but to give in a clear information and let them to aggressive on ball and push the opponent for hard things every time, get out the plan of the first priority at the offense is very helpful for Dijon team's strategy at defense. One thing that they are really being attention for the spot up shots, reaction to the spot up shots. They don't want the opponent have some easy spot up shots, so they give you every time some contested shots or let you to drive to basket and they will be again in a rotation. Some big men come to cover you or let you a pull-up shot from the twos. I give some examples about the percents of the three-point shots, about the spot-up situation, about the pull-up situation. So they know this very well and they don't let you to have some easy spot-up shots. And again, I put here as a disadvantage of this being in a rotation is offensive rebound. They are giving many offensive rebounds because of this, but I think this is a calculation and they are expecting this and they know what they have at their hands. They are pushing themselves enough to get some defensive rebounds, but for sure this is a one disadvantage of this kind of defense. You will see the examples. Again, the same view, the five men all the time on ball, they are showing up at the pick and rolls. They don't let you play with the user, scorer users. Again, one more pass, one more play. Again, helps is coming, eye defense. And after that, you can see maybe this is a poor closeout defense, but this is the thing that they want. After the guy put the ball on the floor, again, one more guy is coming from the rotation and try to contest this shot. At the end, this is a basket maybe, but this is very few examples. And this is the thing that they are expected. They want these points from you. They don't want spot up shots, spot up 3-point shots. Again, you see that how they are aggressive on ball. Every time five men are really close to the ball, like to steal the ball, attacking the ball every time. Again, one more rotation. Again, you see that they let the guy, this is, I think, Baburin, is the very good spot-up shooter, but it doesn't matter for them. They know that how you are comfortable at the spot-up situation. The opponent team make many passes, and they like to create one spot-up shoot position. You see that when the guy get the ball, he's at the maybe clear position, but this number 21 gives a good reaction like the previous examples. Excuse me, this is... Okay. Again, put the ball on the floor, another rotation came, and again, tough situation, but you see that how they are getting the offensive rebound and to put the ball back. This is sometimes happening. I don't want to put the examples about they make the very good clear defense. After that, they steal the ball and they go to fast break. You will see it at the offensive clips, similar examples. But this is the thing that we have to think what we have at our hands about the advantages and disadvantages about the defense that we select. At low post defense, their strategy is to take you out from the low post zone. It doesn't matter, you are very good at low post, you have the mismatch, you have the good matchup or something, it doesn't matter. They have the rule again, they every time coming to double team, and they close every time to middle, they close the view every time. Arms are really aggressive, hands on the ball. They try to deflect the passing lanes. And again, the same situation. They close the middle. They're coming from the baseline. They give you a very very close view for passes. They're putting themselves, their other defenses like a zone. And again, they are ready for the rotation. Jumping on the closeouts, arms active. You see that how the opponents trying to attacking them by the million passes and many situations. And now these days, as you know, the players not patient enough like these examples to find a better opportunity at offense. These are the examples that they are really patient. These opponents are really patient to get some better opportunity. Again, they close the middle, they come into half, no any questions, no hesitation, they know what time they need to come, and they are pushing the guy for a bad pass. You see that reaction? This is a one basic turnover that the teams mostly are doing. All teams are knowing that this team make this help. They never change it. Everybody is prepared, but every time it works. Because they put the very good hustle on this situation. Now, this is the first section of the of the Dijon's team's defensive strategy. I try to tell about the defensive strategy of the Dijon team. These are the simple things that we can put at our every level. Basketball team is a, if it's a U team, if it's a maybe mid-range team or high level team, how you are executed. This is the important thing, because they like to play with a very good rotation. You can see about their stats. They play with the 9 guys and they give all the players, maybe Suleyman is maybe play more than them. This is the Champions League stats. But the minimum guy who take the minute is the he's a later addition of this team, is the Lithuanian guy, Kulvietis. He took around 15 minutes. The minimum guy who takes the minute is 15 minutes and 16 minutes. The others all gets around 20 and higher. So this is one thing that they are using in a very good success, this rotation. If any questions you have about the defense, I like to take at this part, and after that I like to continue on about the offense. Do you have any questions about this section?
If there's any question, let me know, coaches, everybody.
Okay.
Fatih, there are a lot of rotation. Do you suggest, do you advise to youth basketball for going to this rotation defense?
Yeah. This is one thing that this is all about your selection. One time Obradovic told about is if we are going in a 4-5 rotation in one defense, this is a good defense. He told about it, because he wants everybody will be aggressive, and the team know that the all teammates are knowing that which time and which way they are going to rotation. If you prepare your team, this is very useful, and everybody will be alert, because there is no situation that, for example, you will say to your team that we're gonna make switch and you can stop everything else. So if the team, any team, any situation, any strategy, if the team is ready for making rotation, every time it will be very helpful, because the defense never will be stopped. The defense in any situation, transition defense, pick and roll defense, one-on-one defense, if the team is ready for rotation, every time try to find one way to stop the offense. Everybody will be on that mentality. But some teams, for example, before years, we have very good examples about without rotation, without giving any rotation, they built very good defensive strategy. One of them is David Blatt's Darüşşafaka. But they are coming to their arc, like a handball defense. They are trying to use their heights at the matchups, and they are not attacking on ball so much. Every time let you a shot from over their hands. One of them is Bamberg team, is with the Tinikieri. They played in a very good success with this strategy. This is all what you have in your team and what you want to do. This is just a preparation. And what is your selection? I think, for my understanding, I worked many years at youth levels. For my understanding, trying to give in a way the players try to solve the problem and try to help each other. So this is very good thing that if the team is ready for the being aggressiveness and going for some rotations, if the youngsters can use their energy. Otherwise, if you let them to lay down and just wait and don't give some advantages to opponent team, this is an easy way. For sure, you can win with this way at youth team levels, but when you reach a senior team level, you will not use your energy as a young player. You will don't know any rotations and mentally the what he needs to make in team defense, the strategies, and he will not understand easily what he needs to make some defenses, about the trap defenses, about some strategy that senior team level coaches gave to him. So this is going to be very helpful when he play at U team level with this strategy. I think this is my point for sure. What the coaches like to give to their young players, but this is my strategy that this can be very helpful if everybody is at the same page.
Thank you. I think for youth players should use their hands and hustle of contest.
Yeah, I think so. This is going to be very helpful with Ahmet Çakı when I work with him at Efes, at Alba Berlin, at Darüşşafaka. When I work with him, every time we are counting the deflections. Every time. This is why we are try to rely on the defense, and at the same time take an attention about the players. They have to know what is the way of the deflection that we want, not by attacking with full body and losing your balance. What is the thing that about to make in a deflection? Don't attack the ball, don't lose your, don't try to be stupid and try to make a fake steal and let your defense one player less, played one player less. And what is the attacking zones to the ball? What is the places that you don't you won't need to be attacked the ball and let your defense one player less? So this is one strategy you need to be put by thinking, not just by aggressiveness, by body and by energy. You need to think where I need to be attacked. Or for example, you can be at the full court and your team can be covered this, and at that time you can attack the ball. But you are at the, your court, and at that time you don't need to be attacked by the ball to steal or give a disadvantage to your team about the defensive strategy.
Thank you.
Thank you,
Coach. I have two questions. To connecting these teams, this the EuroLeague level, to connecting this to youth level coaching, how is their communication in defense, and what's your recommendation for youth level coaching for teaching communication in defense? And second question is long distance closeout.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Especially for a youth program, what's your idea about two hands up or one hands up to going to close out? Is it better?
First of all, great questions. Thank you for this. First of all, you can see every example. For my understanding, this is like this. If you are a good observer, you can see at every example at youth team level, and also you can see it at EuroLeague level. This defensive strategy that Dijon make is for example, you are making dribble and you catch the ball. At that time, everybody like somebody push the button and everybody will be trace the ball, deny, put the ball at the passing lanes. You can see it. CSKA team is playing like that, and Zalgiris team playing like that is the same. You know, there's a Dijon team can be played, and you can find one example at the U team level also. This is one thing that how you are building the team, what is your priorities, what you like to give to the players. For me, to make a team defense, better team defense, everybody needs to be in a better communication. This aggressiveness giving some communication type, because at these days, especially the new generation, don't like to talk so much. Before days, when we're talking about communication at the court, everybody's talking about somebody gonna speak and rotate everybody else on the court and helping like get this guy like this, like maybe like a NCAA mood, you know. NCAA mood is like when somebody is coming from NCAA directly as a rookie, you can observe him like he's always speaking, but they are giving in four years. Every time they let him to make every action by talking. This is their philosophy. But when you invite one guy, for example, as a domestic guy in Turkey, when you transfer one guy from another team, he don't have this mentality, and you cannot make an injection to him at 25-year-old by, come on, let's talk and try to help to your teammates as this way. So this is going to be one communication system. To be an aggressiveness, and rules must be clear. If rules are clear, it's going to be very helpful for communicate. Communicate is not just talking. Communicate is, if we are at the same page, like an internet site, there is some topics up there. And for example, you go by one team page, and there is right in that roster. For example, you go there, when you pointed the roster, there is 8 sectioners coming. Is the senior team, is the youth team, this. And if everybody at the team, when you point something else, is the same things are open, this is the same communication type. You know, this is not just by talking. If everybody is at the same page, if it's very clear, and if you are going step by step, not loading everything else in the same time, if you are patient, it's going to be a good communication. Nobody needs to talk. Everybody is going to be talk. Get this guy. I get. Okay, it's going to be very helpful. But we need to manage ourselves for the new generation, what they like to do, and what we can give to them. Then if we are going their level to communicate, it's going to be very helpful what we want to give them. Okay, this is one thing that I like to be in a recommend about the guys who are working at the youth teams. We need to go up or go down. We don't know who are communicate better. Maybe youngsters are new generations communicate better. We need to go their level to communicate with them. And so we need to keep it simple and go step by step. And this is not the things that I am telling about the EuroLeague level things. You know, this is every level you can play by this way. You know, every level. This is a hands on the ball, tracing on the ball, deny the passing lanes. But everybody, now it doesn't important. You are a 5-man. You are a little bit slow. No, push 100% yourself and try to deny him. Make some mistakes and face up with these mistakes. Sometimes one faster guy can make one backdoor, and your friend need to be covered, and you need to continue to the other rotation. This is the ways that you give them some clues about the solutions. What is the solutions? For sure, the guy can beat you. Maybe he's faster. You are a 5-man, and you go outside of the 3-point line to deny your guy. At that time, they can beat you by backdoor. At that time, when you face up with them, the guy needs to be ready about this rotation. The other thing about the youth teams level, they can always put their practices some handicap defenses. For example, four offenses, 3 defenses, and let the defense find some solutions. No, if there is 3 defense and 4 offense, there is no guys for the matchup. Everybody needs to help each other and try to defend each other. So try to create some drills like this with the handicap defense. And this is not a fast break drill. This is a half court drill, and this is a defensive drill. They need to understand it. This is not an offensive drill. 4 guys going to be attacked to the 3 guys and find a solution for offense. This is a defensive drill, and the defense have to stop this offense by aggressiveness, by helping each other, by communicate each other, and it's going to be raised up, and you can communicate all things to pick and roll defense, transition defense, and everything else. At that time, when the time will be came, and everybody going to be start to help each other. And if it's the strategy on your mind like this, and if you start from the first day to move in like that, and to the end like this, and you will be rich in a teaching way, the guys that needs to understand what is the way our defense. The second question about the long distance closeout. First of all, this is really tough. You can play at the EuroLeague level with this range. This, you will give this range the long distance way to the guys, and you cannot cover this spot up shoot by this reaction. But sometimes the playing types can be really long, and you need to be covered, and you need to teach the guys don't give up in any situation. Any situation is going to be long way, is going to be short way. But this is one thing that very important. What is your reaction? Sometimes we are making some traps at low post. At low post, when we make a trap defense, when we put one rotation by X rotation to the two guys and one guy will be defense at the middle, I can show you here. Sorry, this is going to be very, very helpful. I try to be quickly. Sorry. As you see at the example, I think this one example that I share is a long distance, about the long distance. This is it. At this one, for example, this guy is reaching to his guy. Sometimes, like this example, from low post, the pass going to corner directly. And the guy who is at the help, this guy, I guy, will be go to the your guy, and the guy needs to run to this guy. They need to make a switch, X switch here. At this situation and in others, in any situation about the closeout, mostly we saw that, for example, the guy is coming to this guy, coming to help and double team to here, and the pass going to corner. These guys mostly thinking that his friend, his teammate, get this guy, and this offense will be over here. It's not going to be continued. But mostly, this guy make an extra pass to number 8, and this guy mostly shooting the ball. At this situation, all the time we are face up with this. Any situation that you are making at close-out situation, at your guy or another guy in the rotation, you need to be run with the pass. You have to teach the guys for the long distance closeout defense, you need to teach the guys, you have to start to run with the pass, not after the guy get the ball. We are mostly making this mistake. This is the habits that you see, that the guy normally don't make the extra pass. This number 8 have the ball now, but the guy know that this guy who is under the rim, the guy know that this pass gonna be reached with the extra pass to here, and he start to run before he pass, and that's why he's coming to there and he's reaching that point by a long distance close out defense. That's the point that you need to give. What is your reaction with the pass? If you are react, you can have a chance. You can have a chance. Not easy, but you can have a chance. This is two things. First, delay the pass by hands. Not a bullet pass. You need one pass is a line, maybe a little bit low pass, not bullet pass. If you let them a one low pass, if it's not fast, and if you start in a very good reaction, you can have maybe a chance about the long distance closeout defense. And you have to teach this, because you will always face up with this situation. I hope that is going to be a helpful answer.
Yes, thank you, coach. I think let's keep going on.
Okay. Now, I like to start with the transition. First of all, I want you to show you their defensive stats. I hope that everybody are showing this. This is their defensive stats. I want to end the defensive part with this. You see that they are at the first place at the Champions League about pushing the opponent to turnover. they are pushing the opponent 18 turnovers. And this is one thing that we need to be equalize what we're telling about the defense before. How the deflection and this rotation is helpful for them with the 18, pushing the opponent 18 turnovers. It's the same at French League. This is why they are success at the French Cup also, to the teams that very strong, like Monaco, like Nanterre, like Asvel team. And I want to let you see that this transition things. First of all, every team can have some transition ability. Every team these days is very important to have some open court points. You cannot, very, very tough to play. Let's say very tough to play half court offense to half court offense. You need to be very, very talented. And all the teams are making cheating defense. The players not very disciplined at the 5-on-5 offense, and they are not patient enough. They are not creative enough. So there is very important thing that you need to find some open court points. This team, like the other teams, for sure have some open court strategy, but they are measured like that. If they have a primary offense, if they are pushing you to turnover and they make a steal over there, or they make a clear rebound, at that time they have a very good reaction. They put the click on and everybody running at the same time. And they have, because of this reaction, they find some easy basket at the open court situation. But I'm not telling about now this reaction and 1-on-0 fast breaks. This is also combined by a transition offense of them. And this is very important thing that mostly time they play with two bigs at the same time. This is very easy, let's say easy to play four guys when they stretch the court, and you can find a transition point by stretching to court by the shooters. And you can put your big guy to the under the rim, and you can have a very good spacing. But their weight is not same. They mostly play around 20, 22 minutes with the two big men who is not great shooters. And so at that time, they need to be share the court very well. You see that how they react for the situation, and they put the ball on the low. And they don't stop, and they are using the passes. Let's please check again how the big guys is running, how they are sharing the court. By just using the pass, rotating the ball, they use one spot up game at their transition offense. One defensive rebound again. And one cross pass. And after that, you see that how they put the bigs as a spacing. Two bigs at the low. They feed the inside after the cross pass, and they use it. This is one point that they are using mostly. They let the defense changing their views when they are throwing the ball. For example, what I mean. First, everybody is watching the point guard here, and everybody, you see that all heads are showing that way. Everybody is looking to point guard. And after that, they let you to rotate your head to this side. And after that, you lose the first, the starting side of the offense. After that, one more pass, like a paint touch, like a drive to inside. And one more time, you change your wheel. And at the end, they attack you at the wheel that that you lose. So they let you every time to changing the wheel. Now this is at our game, at Champions League, we gave a very bad reaction, very bad transition defense. You see that again, they try to change the wheel. This is very tough, for me very tough, at this time, at these days, attacking with the two big men who don't have the shots. So this is going to be very helpful spacings. And you can find Dijon teams games, and you can watch out, and you can improve your philosophy about the transition about this way. This is going to be very helpful for the youth team levels, and you can play by the two big guys and non-shooter guys by this way. But you see that how they are advancing the ball every time. First pass, advancing the ball. They pass in again, they pass in again, and they find it. Just by the passing, they find the opportunity at under the rim. Control the rhythm of the game is a very important strategy of their transition offense. You will see this is not the main thing that they like to attack on you every time by running and running and running. This is one thing. Play the game with the rotation. They use all players at the rotation. Everybody is very energetic. Everybody is running. First of all, this. The other thing is the main point is they react to your losing momentum. How are you losing your momentum? They get some runs, 4-0, 6-0 runs. At that time, they are trying to put one more action on you and try to go maybe 10-0, 12-0 or something. At that time, like a break, they put it up and they again like a somebody push the button, they raise the tempo. At that time, you cannot see this example that I will show you. After the basket, you see that they directly go for a early shot. You cannot see this at Dijon offense every time. You cannot. But they are making this at that time. You see that at the point, normally, Pau Ortiz team is losing by around 8. At that time, they find the 3-point shot, and they are pushing themselves to all momentum. It's going to be like a game part of 8-0 maybe Dijon run on the court. At that time, Pau Ortiz find one shot, but they are raising up the tempo, and they let you do some give ups during the game. So this is one point of them. When they feel it, that you are dropping down a little bit, about maybe some teams playing with a short roster, short lineups, at that time they are attacking you immediately by this way. So they are really controlling when they are need to be attack on you by primary offenses, when they are need to slow down. You will see at the examples that I will give at the offense, at half-court offenses. Player individually is reading and react positions. They are really rely on the guards, is especially decision makers, is the two-point guards, is really raise up the tempo, give some decisions. They are making some many fake drives, early fake drives that I really like. Also in my basketball understanding, you see that how the guy is diving on inside is a paint touch. He knows that he don't gonna make this shot, but he saw that there is a one handicap defense. So this team gonna be help this drive, and he knows this very well, and he may gets a one paint touch and he open a spot up position like this. Again, this is at our game. You see that. First of all, they don't have an opportunity to go for fast break. This is like a 2-on-2 game. But after that, he saw that this is like maybe a handicap defense again. Same point guard. Also, David Olsen is doing this. Again, one. Excuse me. This is again an internet problem, I think. This. Okay. Let's show it again. Again, one drive to let the guys on him, and after that, find the guy at the spot-up situation. They know themselves very well. Again, point guard find the situation. This is the thing. Please watch out this very carefully. I really believe the game momentum. Now you see that this is 5-on-5. There is no any handicap situation, no anything else. But the team, this Beşiktaş team now is really close to give up situation. At that time, like I said to you, they really calculated and they really like to use this situation, this close out, this create a close out situation. One, decoy pick and roll, fake pick and roll. And after that, the guy for sure not going to be use this shot. And after that, they continue again. One more drive, one more paint touch. Extra pass, one more paint touch, and find the easy score. This is the momentum of the game. This is, they are using the momentum. They don't stop, and they use the disadvantage of the defense, the handicap of the defense. And they let you to go by the rotations. This is not the rotation that we are talking about at the first part of the Dijon defense. This is not a very helpful rotation. This is just a give up rotation. This is not the same that we are talking about the first part of the meeting. This is the thing that I like to show at this part. If any question again about the transition part, please let me know, and I want to give the answers about this.
Okay, let me check it. If there is any question, let me know, everybody. Just one question, a little bit. How much is the mental influence in this case?
How you mean? This is, can you open the
mentally? About mentally, how we can prepare for the players, especially for youth program too.
This is especially you will be face up with many turnovers at the youth teams. If your team is a run and gun team, this is the thing that I really like to play in run and gun, like the type of run and gun game. But I work again at the youth team levels, we faced up with many turnovers. But this is the thing that they need to be think about. This is the thing, if they don't control the run and gun game, that I don't mean about hesitation. Don't put an hesitation on run and gun game. If you put an hesitation to a run and gun game, you cannot be going to the success. So you need to give some freedom to your players. But giving a freedom is not mean that make some unforced turnovers. To cut the unforced turnovers, you need to give some strategies. You need to teach them the spacings. This is not the thing that every time everybody's run and make something, make a point without any example that we gave before, you know. For sure, they need to have a freedom. No hesitation, because you need to attack in some limited seconds. At that time, the players needs to be clear, like I told you, at the defensive strategy. So you need to go by step, by reading. They need to read the handicap defenses. They need to read the unbalanced defenses. They need to read mismatch defenses. You need to teach them by this way, and after that, you need to go by step by step. When you teach them this 3 point, maybe I don't remember one, you can put some points more on it. When you teach them as this way, you will put some mentality on it, you know, and you need, you let them to think and play, execute at very short terms at the primary offenses. So without putting any hesitation, for me very important, without putting any information hesitation, let them to make decision making at the same time, but no any unforced turnovers, and this is the way maybe to teach them step by step what is our goals, what is our goals about spacing, what is our goals about mismatch, what is our goals about increase the tempo, increase the rhythm of the game, what is our point about the unbalanced defense, is some defenses are not ready to defending you, finding the closeout situation, be patient. The transition is defense. The transition offense is not means that attacking every time in the first 4 seconds. This is not this every time. Right? If you are trying to teach the guys as this way and trying to give the pass individuals, pass workouts as this way, not just in the half court passing workouts, not just pick and roll passing workouts. At the same time, you are in the now is the open court. What is advancing the ball? What is the cross passes at this situation? What is the putting the ball at the low post? What is the high low pass? What is the low high pass to the cutter? Everything that if you are raising up the skills about the guys that you have about the skill wise, about the fundamental wise, is going to be helpful for unforced turnover. As at that time, you can speak about more at the youth team levels about the transition offenses without hesitation for me. This is run and gun game, not just giving freedom. Giving freedom for sure, but don't let them to get some hesitation. At the same time, to control it by a break. Now we are at the first, now we are at the second, now we are at the three. If you are controlled, this is one weapon for you. If you are not controlled, this is not a thing that you have in your pocket.
I see. Thank you.
There is one question.
Yeah, there is one question from Coach
Jamal. Welcome. Thank you for question. I'm reading. I'm reading from there. Thank you.
What are pleasure to have you all, great coaches here. Okay. Welcome, Jam Coach.
Hello.
Hello.
My question to Fatih.
Yeah, okay.
I'm asking to him the French team. Uh-huh. What are they doing against?
Is 5-on-5
Okay. I mean, you know, are they always with the quick hitters, or they have a continuous set of offenses?
Yeah. Now, Cem abi, at this part, I will show the 5-on-5 offenses. What is this strategy? This team. I will show you, please let me show like this, it's going to be more helpful for us. This is their offensive stats. This is offensive stats of them. Please check their possession number. I show you the transition, how they are going to transition, but they are at the 25th place. You see also at the free throws, they are at the one of the last. They are at the 25th place about field goal attempts. How can a team be a transition team at the same time field goal attempts at the, you will be at the 25th of the Champions League? This is the thing that about their success that I mean. They are controlling when they need to go by the running game. It's an open court game. And when they need to attack on 5-on-5. You will see at the, now this part how they are attacking at 5-on-5 at the half court. They are really try to hold the ball, control the game, and they like to attack at last 4 seconds like EuroLeague teams. So this is their success for me to balance it. They are not like dogs that without rope and going running every time. They are running every time when you see like this. You can see that very easy transition points that they have by pass, by drives, by shooting. Every time they have, but they really good balance it when they have the primary offenses one hand and the other hand when they have the 5-on-5 offenses. Please let me know. Let me start at the last section of the meeting about the 5-on-5 situation. I have very good example. First of all, I like to start with this. This is the slide that I like to show you. This is two strategies they have. One of them is primary offense, but primary offense including about when they catching you with unbalance, they are continue like a transition offense, like a quick hitter, or they prefer to attack you last 8 4-seconds. While the all defensive attention go low. At that time, they are attacking you. Like their strategy at at defense. They how they let you to go far away. This is one example. Very nice. And this is all summary. This is all summary that about their offense. Please check out how many passes they make. One very simple offense. How they rotate the ball, how they are patient. One more, and this is the thing that I like to have an answer about this. If it's a good answer for you, Cem Akta, Cem Koç. This is how they are balanced. This is their strategy and great summary about their offense. This is one option. And after that, please let me share with you about their plays. What is their strategy about their pick and roll offense? First, start with this. First of all, they prefer to play the pick and roll offense to the sidelines because they like to attack to you by weak side helps. They really like to attack to weak side helps. How they defend, how they let you attack on them, they let you defend you as this way. This is, I think, very combined strategy. And they are using many things when they're attacking on you by pick and roll offense. For example, they are attacking by the sideline pick and roll offense. This does not mean that they are attacking to the middle. They are attacking to the sideline. Like, think about like a horns play and you are attacking from elbow extension to the sideline. And the second thing is replace. Replace is very important thing. Everybody is moving by the user is attacking to the paint. Everybody is moving. You will see the examples. They really like to attacking opposite side of the screen, reject screens every time. They are really like to, especially off the catch pick and rolls, they really like to attack opposite side of the screens. And one thing the bigs have is they are really good passers for me, but at the same time they improve their skills by the team strategy. When they put the ball to the roller from the user, they immediately pass to the outside. You will see very good examples about their plays. This is the thing that weak side, how they attack to. This is the example that I try to show you. This is one back pick and roll situation from Monaco game. Very well defensive team at French League. And they are very aggressive every time. They are always, this is very simple. They direct the pass to the weak side. This is the simple example that they want. But not everything is happening like this. They are attacking again to the sideline. You see that two guys at the weak side, they directly reverse the ball. They are attacking by 2-on-1 many times, million examples as this way. I showed the first example is the long one. Now I'm going by step by step how they are going. This you see at the first example, the directly with the bullet pass, the guy shoot the ball. The second example, they are attacking to 2-on-1 situation. Again to the sideline pick and roll. You see that this is a fake pick and roll. This is not a real pick and roll. But immediately the guy, the guy is a little bit inside, pass over there and using the closeout situation. Everybody is moving because of this and they are using many passes, inside out passes. And they are attacking by you as this way. Again, starting one decoy pick and roll to the sideline. One more pick and roll, one back pick situation. One more, they are really, really patient for this. And you see that how the guy, please check out 83 and this guy who is at the, he will be at the ball side. They were at the weak side, but now they are at the ball side. How they are moving, this is spontaneous. Every time they know how to move, everybody, you see that nobody is stopping. Everybody is moving around and the guy needs to be defended by 1-on-1. And believe me, this Nizhny Novgorod team, who is now the opponent of them, they really worked for Dijon team and they prepared. anyhow, they found this score by this way, because their solution is read and react. How they are reacting? They are at that time, they have a reading for this. Never give up by the moving and using the, again, you see that they attack at the last 4 seconds while the attentions, one guy, as you see, the guy is number 9. These two guys nearly the closing the losing his their communication, also attention. At that time, they are attacking you by this way, last 5-4 seconds, and using the shot. Again, one more replacing situation. Every time you see that these two guys is changing, by the way, and you will see at the at our also YouTube Tubat's YouTube site, you will see that Ahmet Çakı's clinic about the using the spacing at the Spanish league. You see that this guy, how he is sitting far away from the arc, and this guy knows that because of the individual individuals, they are knowing the individuals. This guy knowing that he needs to be stay with him. Because of that, they opened the court like that. So I counted this guy also moving without ball very well as this way. And they are sharing the replace situation as this way. Reject screen many times. I put as an example like this. I'm really believing about this situation. We use this at Beşiktaş also with İsmet Akpınar. He likes to reject screens every time as this way, because the teams are not ready for this situation. And I believe that it's better to attack one team by isolation set offense, is attacking to by rejecting screen to them, because you take out the big man and prepare to let him to prepare for pick and roll defense like this way. If you are attacking him by isolation, this guy will be more inside and try to be in a maybe rotation. But as this way, when you are attacking to the opposite side of the screen, the teams are mostly not ready and they push the alarm button, and this guy is coming immediately. This guy can be calm. This guy will be needs help and some imbalance. You can create some unbalanced defense and open up again. You see that how they are using the weak side, mostly like this. One guy that who is open, at that time they use the spot up game. And like I told you at the first topic, how they are using mostly, these are the big guys' success. When they put the ball, again, one pick and roll to the sideline, you see that what this guy have a target about to going this way, no any targets. But you have to stop him, because if you don't make a show up to him, if you give him a drop defense, this guy will be scored the ball. This is the best scorer of this team and MVP of the French Cup. And you have to stop this guy. I show you the example about not the basic ones. For sure, many basic ones you will have. This guy will be make drop defense, wait you inside, and this number one will be make the pull up or attacking here, use this passes, kicks out, and punish you as this way. But when he saws one hedge defense like this way, he goes to open up the game, and they are making one fake decoy pick and roll game and using the weak side action. You see that there is also 2-on-1 position again, but the guy don't prefer to give the 45 pass, and after that attack directly to the closeout. Again to the sideline pick and roll, one fake pick and roll, mostly fake pick and rolls. Again one more pick and roll. They this team prefer to turn to zone to defend after some actions. This power test team try many things. Again inside outside pass, and after that using 2-on-1 situation. They use low post offense, as I told you at the first transition part, try to change the view of the defense, not attacking from the low post. This is very good point. They don't think that we don't have a low post guy, so let's go to cancel the low post offenses. They prefer to attack from low post to change the view of the defense. They think it like a drive, and somebody drive and kick the ball outside. They think it is this way. So they put the ball on low to let you to change the view. After they make many actions and they kick the ball out and again to put the ball in or drive again or find a spot up shot. So this is the strategy about, this is the Salah that who has very, I think, poor low post offensive guy. Is mainly he's a pick and roll offensive guy, we can say, maybe good rim runner, but maybe good offensive rebounder, but the fourth individual thing, maybe fifth individual thing, maybe he's a low post guy. But they put the ball on the low post, and after that they are moving and try to catch the guys. They push you to make one mistakes and one spot up game, or they try to punish you from a bad communication like this after a screen or cut. Every time looking for this, they are looking for this. And rules are very clear. You see that while this guy cut, because of this bad communication, they give one and two spot up game more. They give two more spot up game because of this. They create one emergency thing in their paint. I want to show you one more example. After pick and rolls also, they try to use high-low passes. Again, they are playing with two big guys who don't have three-point shots. You see that again. Richard Solomon take the three-point shot. This guy, Kasang, the other five men, is the French guy. This Leloup, this 21. These are three guys who are like a very mobile five men. It's like a combo, we can say, who are more closer to five men, but who can play like a four, who can defend the four guys, four-man guys. Not the fastest guys, not the close-out guys, but if there is a clear opportunity like this, at that time they just shot the ball. I think is Richard Solomon average is 0.9, 0.8 per game, not one three-point shot. Kasang is same, 0.91 or something. This is around one. Is Leloup is same. They are not using four times, five times three-point shot at every game. They are the guys that they are playing together every game in 20, 22 minutes, 25 minutes, and they are just using maybe one attempt like this way. And if it's very, very clear at that time, they are using, if they are feeling very comfortable. And as you see, they also create one more two-on-one position as here by using maybe to pass to Ulmer. This is the last part that I want to tell about the Dijon team. I really interest if there is any questions about these things.
Thank you so much, Coach. That was so clearly and was great analysis from you. If there is any question, let me know, please.
Do you have any questions? At that time, I want to show some views. These are the stats of these stats is a say or this view is drawn by a state organization that I really like, is Providence University. Is the when you deflect one player, when you arm up, how you let the guys lose in the view of the passing situation of the view. Is the player lose 65 degrees view than when you hand down just looking on his face. This is the one thing that very clear, and how we need to be put on some things more about the deflection. This is the second thing about offense that I try to tell about the analyze also, why they are trying to take out the opponent teams from spot up game, and why they are trying to find and create the spot up game. This is about the, for example, if this is a EuroLeague stat, one company made this. This is before season. This is, I think, one or two years before season. This is about the subject. One player who has 40% 3-point shot at EuroLeague, but how we count the 40%? What is which kind of shoots are inside of this 40%? 35% of 3-point shots are just spot up shots. 29% of them contest spot up shots. 11% of them 3-point pull up. 10% of it contest pull up. Shuffle as the replace shots. This 8% is increased. At the last two years at EuroLeague, is reached to 11% more replace shots now is playing at EuroLeague now, and the time situation. So when we count one guy's 40%, this guy, for example, Fatih shooting the ball with 40%, we are not counting just spot up shots or contest shots or pull up shots. This is a combine of all of your 3-point shots. So this must be your team strategy that with this stat, maybe it's going to be more helpful. This is going to be more helpful about to explain what spot ups gave us. Is the when we shoot the ball is going to be, is the, again, one from same player. When this player shoot the ball from spot up, his success is 48%. But is a contest spot up is going to be a 80% lower. Or if it's going to be a pull-up 3-point shot, it's going to be 20% lower success they have. This is the thing that I like to share with all you coaches here. This is the how their strategy going to be rely on spot up shots, and how, why they are trying to take out you. You asked me a question about the rotation. How, why they are trying to take out you, and don't give up. If it's a long range, it doesn't matter, to take you out from the 3-point spot up shot, and prefer you to let you have one runner floater or pull up twos or contest shots. This is the way of them to let you know about by also the stats that I mean.
Thank you so much, Coach, for taking out your precious time to attend us, lecture a topic for our coaches. Thank you so much. Have a good time, and stay safe, Paul. Stay safe, Coach.
Thank you very much. I hope everybody enjoy, and it's going to be helpful for everybody else.
Hayırlı Ramazanlar.
Hayırlı Ramazanlar. Thank you.